Nearly a decade after the Great Recession, the pace of creating a new business is still slower than it was back in 2007. A new report finds a small uptick this year, including in the U.S. When it comes to tech startups, the image is often of young white men in hoodies. But it turns out African-American women control about 1.3 million businesses, and they are the country's fastest growing group of entrepreneurs. Special correspondent April Brown recently met two women trying to break into the club.
I love peanut butter. You like peanut butter?
Zola Bowie works as a caregiver in the San Francisco Bay Area for a company called Oneva. She can often be found watching the Santos family's three kids, who are all under the age of four.
Good, keep eating.
The children's mother, Arlene Santos, says she couldn't run her tech company without the help.
As a career woman, you don't want to feel guilty that you have a meeting. You want to make sure that home life is taken care of. And that's really what Oneva does.
And did you want to go shopping after the walk?
Yeah.
Marvie Jean Darden, who also lives in the Bay Area, had a stroke 2 years ago and is nearly blind. But she wants to remain in her home as long as possible.
After I had the stroke, I couldn't do what I had done before. I also worried about different people that we didn't know coming into the home and everything.
We're going to start with doing the arm stretches first.
But since Oneva introduced Mrs. Darden to Sedon Thomas, those problems have been solved.
Four.
She's more than a caregiver. You know, I feel like she's a friend.
Several of Mrs. Darden's adult children live nearby, but have busy lives and children of their own.
Two.
Anita Darden-Gardine is one of them, and part of the so-called sandwich generation, with elder and child care needs. She has an 11-year-old daughter, and Marvie Jean is her mother. Gardine realized many others had the same issues, so in 2014, she came up with the idea for Oneva, a service providing FBI background-checked care providers that customers can learn more about before they ever enter the home.
I'm Zola, and I'm an Oneva caregiver.
Gardine's business currently provides helpers for her parents, the Santoses, and 60 other clients. But being an African-American woman entrepreneur is not without its challenges.
Our biggest challenge is cash. We have to turn stones that some folks don't have to. I mean, in all candor, I don't have the hoodie, and I'm not the 20-something that most people expect to see or would want to invest in when you think about who in Silicon Valley is most likely to be able to secure that investment.
At a 2015 startup competition, Gardine was about to make a pitch for Oneva when a potential investor turned to her husband, Bob, Oneva's chief technology officer, and another business partner.
He just looked at them and the two men and said, "You're going to let the black girl pitch." And that one floored me.
What was going through your head?
I was angry. I literally had to remove myself. You certainly believe as a woman you've done all the appropriate things that one needs to do to be competitive as a CEO. And it's disappointing when all that work is culminating in someone minimizing you as just a black girl.
Gardine ended up winning the competition and being named Best Startup of 2015. Nevertheless, she's had a tough time getting the attention of venture capitalists, or VCs. So Gardine is seeking alternative funding sources like Kiva, the crowdfunding site that lets people invest in the company for as little as $25.
So when we actually lend to Anita or lend to Oneva, they'll actually do it through a PayPal account.
The goal? $10,000.
Across the board, women start businesses with less money than men, whether they're in technology or whether they're in consumer products or whatever. It's about half, 50%. This is a worldwide statistic.
Candida Brush is a professor of entrepreneurship at Babson College near Boston. She says Gardine's financial struggle is not unique.
For minority-owned businesses, so female-owned, black-owned firms start with half the money of male black-owned firms. And all minorities start with less money than non-black firms. So it's a challenge.
VCs generally don't look like me from a racial perspective or gender perspective. I think that we're seeing that change, particularly because of changing demographics. Millennials, especially millennial women, are crashing through ceilings in ways that my generation was not always able to. So certainly I'm optimistic about the future.
Angel Rich is one of those millennials trying to break through the glass ceiling, not only for African-American women entrepreneurs, but for game developers. She started a Washington, D.C.-based company called The Wealth Factory, which recently developed a free gaming app called Credit Stacker.
We want kids like you to know exactly what to do with their money before they actually have the chance to spend it. Credit Stacker teaches people how to make wise credit decisions. Essentially, you have to swap various pieces around that represent monthly payments, so you have your home loan, your student loans, your car loans, and so forth. Ah, we have another multiple choice question. There's also a credit score that calculates as your score, and there's multiple choice questions built in to assess your knowledge along the way.
And why a game?
We feel as though a game almost tricks people into having fun, and they end up learning how to manage their money at the same time.
And as for money for her own startup?
We were honored to recently be the global winner of JP Morgan Chase Financial Inclusion Competition for the best solution in the world for serving vulnerable populations. They provided us with a $10,000 grant to turn our online version into the mobile app.
Winning a $10,000 grant to help improve the financial literacy of students and families in underserved communities does help.
Thank you.
However,
funding is definitely an issue for us. We've been very creative at bootstrapping this company off of revenue since 2014.
What is bootstrapping for those who don't know?
So bootstrapping essentially means operating with no cash. You have to become very creative as to how you come up with things. So for instance, we brought on 15 recent graduates, gave them work experience to develop the game and job recommendations, and in turn, we were able to develop our game for free.
What we find is that women tend to be more resourceful and they tend to bootstrap their businesses a little bit better. And so in the long run, what that means is that they tend to survive and they may not grow as rapidly, but they tend to be more sustainable in certain ways.
When you look at sort of spheres of influence when you're raising money, it really comes down to sort of who you know and who you have access to. So I'm hopeful that in the future, those pipelines will be opened up more to diverse communities and the Black population in general.
Back in the Bay Area, Oneva is ramping up to potentially serve more families like the Santoses.
Whee! All right.
The company recently signed a deal with a Seattle-based Fortune 50 tech firm that will offer the service as a wellness benefit to employees. No upfront money for Oneva, but immediate access to thousands of potential clients. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm April Brown in San Francisco.